second tip trick video, I'm going to be doing some oxy-fuel cutting. This is something I do on a daily basis, and it's the fastest, easiest way for us to cut steel out in the field. But there's some things to remember whenever you're setting up oxy-fuel cutting, so I'm going to walk you through those.
First thing you're going to do is set up your regulators on your bottles and then your hoses. Make sure you're using the right size wrenches. 1 1/8 for your regulator, 11/16 for the hoses. I see so many guys use channel locks, adjustables, whatever they have laying around, and that'll mar up the brass. Once you're set up, set your regulators. I like to run my acetylene around 5 psi and my oxygen around 50 psi for general cutting. I'm going to be burning out some 3/8 plate, 4 lifting lugs for my welding skid. For layout, I like to use a silver welder's pencil. It makes a nice straight, clean line. That's easy to follow. For this thickness of plate, I'm going to be using a number 0 torch tip. If you're using a used tip, make sure it's clean. Torch tip cleaner. Make sure all your holes are open and clear. Otherwise, that'll show up in your cut. Another thing to keep in mind is when you're doing your layout, account for your kerf. That's the width of your cut. In this case, with a number 0 tip, that's about 1/16 of an inch.
When you turn your acetylene on and light it, you want to turn your oxygen knob and press the lever. Turn that knob until the tip of the flame cleans up. That's right where you want to be to cut. You're going to point that tip away from yourself when you're piercing, like cutting these holes, until you blow through, and then that'll keep the metal from hitting, coming back at you.
I gave those plates a minute to cool down, and I cleaned up slag off of them, and they're pretty good. That's what you're looking for. Straight lines. Your slag should be easy to be removed. And I hope that helps some of you guys starting out.